is Invictus by William Ernest Henley. Out of the night that covers me, black as the pit from pole to pole, I think whatever gods made me for my unconquerable soul. In the fell clutch of circumstance, I have not winced nor cried aloud. Under the bludgeonings of chance, my head is bloody, but unbowed. Beyond this place of wrath and tears looms but the horror of the shade, and yet the menace of the years finds and shall find me unafraid. It matters not how straight the gate, how charged with punishments the scroll. I am the master of my fate. I am the captain of my soul. And with that, I'd like to invite my other generational cohorts. Crystal, Devyn, Marvin, join me on stage. Yes, I will read what I wrote in the program, because I feel it's the most apropos thing that I felt. Okay, to Big Daddy. What could I possibly say about this man that can't be said more eloquently by others? What can I say that would be more introspective, more personal? It's a tough question. Big Daddy was always a stoic presence, blunt and consistent, with little patience for beating around the bush. An unyielding pragmatist who took a lot of convincing, like a lot. He often aimed to teach us grandchildren about the harsh realities of the world, stressing the importance of a strong work ethic, the power of dedication, the pride in productivity. There were more than a few occasions growing up where my artistic sensibilities were at direct odds with his worldview. Yet even when he didn't understand my perspective, he still supported it after many, many years of the aforementioned convincing, of course. He still made sure I got to Oxford, studying a subject that might as well have been a course in pixie magic for all he understood. And yet he still came to the plays, watched all the shows, and smiled in his understated manner as he lent his time, support, and guidance along what would be a long and difficult journey for me. What can I say to you, Big Daddy? I can say thank you. Even though the depth of gratitude isn't adequately represented in words, I can still say it. I stand on the shoulders of so many who have sacrificed and given for a dream that wasn't their own. And now, as a grown man, finally moving forward on a path I started long ago, as I said goodbye to this monolithic family figure, the most apropos, the most just words that I can muster, I thank you for all that you did in this life. Thank you.